Hi, I'm going to do a quick tip here on spraying technique and equipment that I use. So right off the bat, all sprayers come with a gun like this. It's really basic and gives you pretty close to the surface spraying. I don't recommend painting large surfaces with just this. The main reason for this is that you have to keep the sprayer head about a half a foot from the surface and maintain a constant speed. And if there's anything on the floor or hose gets in the way, it'll trip you up and you'll lose cadence. Another drawback is that you get a lot of overspray on you because your hand is right there next to the surface. So I recommend at least one spray gun extender and hose whip. The extender is preference in my case. Some painters do without it, but the hose whip is definitely a must. You can find these pretty much anywhere. The only drawback that I'm aware of for the hose whip and the extender is that when you actuate to release the gun, it occasionally spits large droplets on the surface. And then for me, I rarely run into it, but I usually try and avoid it by starting the spray off of the surface, so like on the wall. And that overlap on the wall also gives you a spot to cut in for when you're doing the color on the wall. There's another thing that I use in my setup, and that's the sprayer head angle from Graco, seen here. This, at least for me, is a game changer when it comes to leverage. It allows me to use the extender to its full potential and allows me to spray directly onto the surface squarely, which you have to do when you're spraying. Make sure you get the branded one. I bought a bunch of different cheap ones online, and they broke or they caused problems or there was some kind of leak, and it's just a nightmare. It's worth getting the high-end one for this. And for the last bit, technique. This is kind of an important one. Doesn't matter what equipment you're using. You want to be about a half a foot from the surface. If your pressure's too low, you'll get banding. You generally want to try, if I'm using an X5 in this case, so I max it out with a 415 tip. And the tips usually last about 3 or 4 jobs. You can usually push it to about 5, but it starts banding when you don't replace it after a certain number of jobs, so make sure to do that. The fan has to be square to the surface, and you want to keep a nice, good cadence, kind of like what I got here. You don't want to hold the sprayer head, or the sprayer fan, against the surface for more than a split second, because you'll pretty quickly accumulate paint in that spot, and it'll run or drip. And then you got a mess to clean up, so, yeah. And, sometimes you need 2 coats. Yeah, sometimes you'll see the lines, so you got to put on 2 coats. I'm doing the ceiling in this case, in this video here. I like to spray the ceiling and the doors and the trim pieces and the door jams and the doors all together. So ceiling first, then doors and trims and stuff like that. And then I roll from where the ceiling and the wall meet in the corner. Another thing that I forgot to mention was that when you're putting down these lines, you got to put down about half of your fan when you progress. So you're going to have half of the spray is going to be going over what you just previously sprayed. So you're always progressing half a fan at a time. That about covers it. Good luck out there. Happy spraying. Peace.